the next group of people. Thank you so much. So if you will proceed forwards with your tickets out and ready.
It's opening night at the TriBeca Film Festival for a movie you've probably never heard of. But for director Onur Tükel, it could change everything.
You could have the best night of your life, although already it's feeling like the worst night of my life because everything could go wrong.
He's the creator and star of Summer of Blood, a low-budget romantic comedy about a neurotic 40-something with a vampire twist. The entire project was made for just $30,000, with many of the actors and crew working for free.
I'm in New York and I've made a couple of movies and wow, it's working out. And like, of course, I haven't had wild success, but they're getting made and they're getting appreciated. The fact that we're in TriBeca is a victory in itself.
For aspiring filmmakers, exposure is everything. And being selected to play at a major film festival can make all the difference. But the movie business is renowned for being a tough industry to break into.
Playing your film in front of an audience in a movie theater is unfortunately becoming more of a rarity these days, so I think festivals really provide that platform for filmmakers to have that experience that they've been hoping for.
The selection of Summer of Blood here now means Onur has been invited to other festivals around the world. But for this director, the ultimate goal isn't necessarily winning awards, but to carry on doing the thing he loves.
So for me, it's having fun. I'm not motivated by money, but at the same time, I do want to find a way to make some money at this so that, you know, we can make bigger and better movies, more ambitious movies, I guess.
And in a city that often looks like a film set, it's a sentiment many aspire to.
These days, it's much easier to make movies on small, affordable cameras using social media to get some kind of audience. But without things like the TriBeca Film Festival, these potential stars of tomorrow might not get the chance they now have. Andy Gallagher, Al Jazeera, New York.